for the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world. From the capital city of the United States of America, Washington, D.C., ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
One popular journal stated, it won't be a celebrity-studded crowd, oh really? Well, how about Jack Nicholson, the star of Entourage, Jeremy Piven, Denzel Washington in his New York Yankee cap, Cedric the Entertainer. Nearby Cedric, Mariah Carey with her group, including husband Nick Cannon, P. Diddy at ringside tonight, and also J. Bodies and Belts, the best known of the belt-holding fighters, Timothy Bradley, one governing fighter, a body stripped him a couple of weeks ago. The other two fighters, Kotelnik and Urengo, still have belts. Bradley has one too. But the really good fighters, the best fighters in the picture, are Ricky Hatton, who's still the linear champion of the 140-pound weight class, Manny Pacquiao, who can become the linear champion by winning the fight, Floyd Mayweather, who is a potential targeted opponent for both of them and against whom a fight would probably have to take place at a catchweight somewhere between 140 and 147. Juan Manuel Marquez, who's never fought against above 135, but who has now accepted an assignment to fight Mayweather somewhere above 140 later this summer, and if he wins that fight, could conceivably fight in the future in this weight division.
Alas ng silangan, alam ng puso, sa dibdib mo'y buhay. Upang hinira, tuyang ka ng mag-ibig, sa manggulubig, di ka pasisihin. Sa lagat ang mundo, sa simoy at sa langit mong bukaw, may dilaw ang tula at awit sa paglayang minamahal. Ang kislap ng wataw at mo'y tagumpay na nang niningning, ang bituin at araw niya kailan ang may di magdidilim. Lupa ng araw ng walhati pagsinta, buhay ay lapit sa kaya na pag may mang-aapi ang mamatay na dahil sa'yo.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, here to sing God Save the Queen, Sir Tom Jones.
God save our gracious Queen, long live our noble Queen, God save our Queen. Send her victorious, happy and glorious, long to reign over us. God save our
Now, ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing. Gentlemen, remove your caps. Here to sing the national anthem of the United States of America, please welcome Jasmine Villegas.
Oh, say can you see by dawn's early light, what shall proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets rang loud, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free? And the home
Jim, tail of the tape for Manny Pacquiao versus Ricky Hatton. You can see that they are even numerically in age. Hatton just a little bit older than Pacquiao. A one-inch height advantage to the Filipino fighter, who is regarded by many as the smaller man. Arm length advantage also to Pacquiao by 1 inch, measured from the armpit to the end of the fist. Hatton weighed in right on the 140-pound weight limit, so familiar to him throughout his entire career. Pacquiao was 2 pounds under at 138 tonight, unofficially. Pacquiao goes up 10 pounds to 148. Hatton goes up 12 pounds to 152, unofficially. A four-round weight advantage in the ring for Ricky Hatton. Rules of the bout with our unofficial ringside scorer, Harold Letterman.
The Manny Pacquiao-Ricky Hatton fight is scheduled for 12 rounds using the unified rules of the Association of Boxing Commissions. There is no three knockdown rule. Only the referee can stop the fight. Case of cut is caused by an accidental headbutt. We go to the scorecards. If the four rounds have been completed, and you cannot be saved by the bell in any round, including the 12th and final round. Jim!
Yeah, Jim, something unusual. Ricky Hatton, the longtime junior welterweight champion, still the linear champion, entitled to walk out second, which has always been considered a psychological sign of status, elected to come out first. And when I asked him about it just a little while ago, he said, Manny Pacquiao is pound for pound the best in the world. That's what I'm fighting for, and I consider myself the challenger for that title. He never heard anything like that.
Yeah, even though he holds officially the world title.
Yeah, yeah.
That's a lot of humbleness on his part.
Well, it also goes to show you that Ricky Hatton is a brilliant marketer who understands how to cast the stakes here in the highest possible region and how to make the fight seem the most important it can possibly seem. Ricky Hatton knows how to attract fans. That's 100% clear. And incidentally, there was almost an outburst during the national anthem when his picture appeared on the big monitor in the arena. And here he comes.
He's fat. He's never been on a diet. And it's Aren't we accustomed to hearing Blue Moon at this point? And the frequent tribute to Hatton's father's background with the Manchester City soccer team? This entrance has been changed up.
Another change up. Tonight is here
for you. And his fans don't seem to know exactly how to react. They're waiting for Blue Moon. In his last performance here against Paulie Malignaggi, he says that he showed the improved boxing skills provided by trainer Floyd Mayweather.
And said that he returned to the scene of the crime when he rushed to Mayweather to get rid of the evidence.
One question surrounding tonight's bout: will he actually try to box, or will he throw himself at Pacquiao and try to establish physical advantages early? And now here comes Blue Moon. Hatton's crowd relatively reserved tonight, seemingly thrown off a little bit by him entering first and the absence of Blue Moon, except as a bit of an encore. And now the Filipino crowd gets ready for Manny Pacquiao, who shows the happiness that always seems to envelop him. Amid his chaotic life, Emmanuel, he never seems anything other than totally joyful at being Manny Pacquiao.
He loves people. He loves boxing, fighting, the excitement that goes with it, the adulation, the crowd. He was born to be a prize fighter.
Neither one of these fighters walks to the ring like they think it's the last mile. No matter how many times they do it, it's like the first mile. Among other things, they're going to each make a minimum of $12 million, which should put a smile on anyone's face.
To the ring from the Philippines, the Pacman.
Just over Pacquiao's right shoulder, Michael Moore, one-time heavyweight champion of the world, and now the apparently anointed inheritor somewhere down the road to Freddie Roach's training operation.
Yeah, and he's done a great job. Seemed to have a good chemistry between the three of them.
And there's Freddie from behind, making himself almost inconspicuous somewhere in the Pacquiao entourage. So much of the buildup to the fight has centered on the two trainers. For his part, Roach was visibly relieved after the weigh-in yesterday, saying, okay, from now on, it's about the fighters. Thank heaven for that.
Well, we have two non-American fighters, two American trainers, three American judges. And the trainers have been the subplot, and they've made it even bigger than anybody anticipated.
One big credit hanging over the fight for Pacquiao. How much credit truly does he deserve for his conquest of De La Hoya? Did it prove that he could beat a quality bigger man? Or did it prove only that he could batter the shell of what once was De La Hoya? Let's go to Michael Buffer now for the official introduction.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the MGM Grand of Las Vegas, Bob Arum's Top Rank Incorporated and Oscar De La Hoya's Golden Boy Promotions, in association with MP Promotions and Hatton Promotions, are proud to present the main event of the evening, 12 rounds of boxing for the IBO and Ring Magazine Light Welterweight Championship of the World. Sponsored by Rockstar, party like a rockstar, Tecate Cerveza con Carácter, Southwest Airlines, low fares, no hidden fees, and smart communications. Sanctioned by the Nevada State Athletic Commission, Chairman Bill Brady, Executive Director Keith Kaiser, IBO President Ed Levine. At ringside, the three judges scoring this bout, Michael Pernick, C.J. Ross, and Glenn Trowbridge. And inside the ring, your referee in charge of the action at the bell, Kenny Bayless. And now, with their places secured in the Hall of Fame, only one can become victorious tonight. So from the MGM Grand of Las Vegas, for the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! Fighting out of the blue corner, with his head trainer, Floyd Mayweather Sr., wearing black with white and silver. Official weight, 140 pounds. Professional record, 46 fights. 45 victories, including 32 knockouts, with only one defeat. From Manchester, England, the three-time world champion and reigning defending IBO Ring Magazine light welterweight champion of the world, Ricky Hitman Hatton.
Let's go.
And fighting out of the red corner with head trainer Freddie Roach, wearing white with blue, officially weighing 138 pounds. Professional record, 53 fights, 48 victories, including 36 knockouts, 3 defeats, and 2 draws. From Sarangani Province, Philippines, the 5-time world champion, currently recognized as pound for pound, the best fighter in the world, Manny Pacman.
Okay, gentlemen, trunks are okay here. Trunks are okay here. Now, gentlemen, we went over the rules in the dressing room. I want to caution you to keep the fight clean at all times, protect yourself at all times, and what I say, you must obey. Good luck. Touch up.
All right.
They are warrior kings with armies of fans who follow them to the battle. Now, they will be alone in the battle.
After a long publicity tour and a lot of exposure to each other, they are genuinely friendly. They like each other. It should not show up in the fight.
No.
Question one, is round one a boxing match? Or does Hatton want to fight right away?
No, what Ricky is doing is the keys of victory, which we didn't have a chance to show to the audience, was for him to create anxiety and pressure on Manny, unlike anybody else has ever did before. But you have to watch Manny, because Manny is still the better puncher between the two, so he still must be a little careful.
So Hatton wants to apply pressure, but with care.
Yes, with
against
care.
Pacquiao's faster hands.
Yes. And I think he's doing just that.
Hard right hand by Pacquiao, trying to hit Hatton as he comes in. Key element of the game plan for Pacquiao, allow Hatton to come forward, catch him on the way in. A key element of the game plan for Hatton, get Pacquiao against the ropes, just like that.
Pacquiao has been more successful with the right than the left. That punch missed. There's the right again landing.
Quick right hooks are landing for Pacquiao. The left hand is overshooting the target.
This fight is living up to the anxiety that the fans expected and the intensity. It's going to be an important factor to see how Kitty Bayless handles this fight, because it could be exciting and it could end up being a very wrestling type match also.
Great right hand for Hatton glazed across the face of Pacquiao.
Hatton's face is already red.
I thought Pacquiao landed the right hook.
I think Pacquiao's landed three significant right hooks already in the fight, Emmanuel. It's definitely been his best punch early. Straight jab lands for Pacquiao.
Which again shows that he's no longer a one-punch puncher.
Well, follows the jab with a hook, comes back with another jab. There's the straight left hand, and he landed it right on Hatton's chin. And down goes Hatton after he swings and misses with a left hook. And that's a knockdown for Manny Pacquiao. Perfect right hand inside.
Well, I don't know if Vicky's going to survive. I'm surprised to see him get hurt for shoulder. But, you know, he's not the type of a guy that goes out to survive. He's a fighter.
Hatton got a couple of extra seconds as Bayless tried to back Pacquiao off. Pacquiao was coming out of the neutral corner in a hurry. Lands another right hook.
Pacquiao's hands are so fast.
Pacquiao's hands are blindingly fast.
His hands are so fast that no opponent sees the punches coming.
Another perfect right hand for Pacquiao. Another right hook. Straight left hand. Pacquiao's landing at will. Hard left hand. Hatton has to hold on. Will Hatton make it out of the round? He's down for the second time. This is the brilliance of the Filipino slugger. A tsunami for Manny Pacquiao in round one. Knockdown, Emmanuel.
Right hook as he was coming in. Never saw it. And what's amazing to see him land a punch and then slip a punch all at the same time shows unbelievable coordination.
The issue has always been
timing.
Whether Hatton could get to Pacquiao and avoid these kinds of clean punches.
CompuBox numbers in round one, utterly devastating to Pacquiao's chances. Pacquiao is 35 out of 62, 31 out of 52 power shots. Hatton only 8 out of 33. It was a Pacquiao storm in the first round.
This, and we have to remember now, although it's a different type of fight, that Pacquiao knocked Marquez down 3 times in the first round.
And then Marquez, a counterpuncher, began to solve him. Hatton is not a counterpuncher. Hard left hand by Hatton. Ricky has decided to fight fire with fire.
And what he's going to have to do in this case, Sherry, he just is try to smother this guy and get close. He's trying to punch at a certain distance. Pacquiao is actually just too sharp and accurate to punch him.
You heard Floyd Mayweather saying to Hatton, you can't just jump all over him. You've got to move your head. You've got to think. You've got to do the things we talked about in training camp. Hatton seemed to believe that he could physically overpower Pacquiao from the beginning.
Yeah, he knew in the beginning he was going to take the risk of getting caught, and he did. Because, you know, coming in, Pacquiao still is the puncher. The physical strength is still with Hatton, but the punch is still Pacquiao.
Hard left hand by Pacquiao. Stunned Hatton and knocked him back. Look at the brilliant accuracy of Manny Pacquiao. Landing with both right and left hands. Misses the right hook there.
What Ricky needs to do is to smother him. He cannot see to deal with those punches. He needs to push him. Just what he's doing there.
Good left hook inside by Hatton. And then he closed down Pacquiao's left side. Hard right hand again by Pacquiao. Ricky can't see the hook coming.
Not behind the head. All right, okay.
Kenny Bayless almost warns Hatton for holding behind the head.
In Hatton's most famous victory over Costazu, he just smothered him and didn't allow him to get off. He can't seem to be able to get close enough to Pacquiao often enough to do that. And Pacquiao's hands are so quick.
That's the point. Costazu had about a quarter of the speed of Manny Pacquiao.
Pacquiao's
blinding speed that sets him apart.
As well as his head movement. His head movement is just a phenomenal. I don't think he's landed too much out of that exchange, but it just is his ability to punch, maintain balance, which he used to couldn't do. And his head movement is just too difficult for Hatton to time.
I think Pacquiao may have spent the first 2 minutes of this round thinking knockout and allowed himself to get a little wild. Now he goes back to more precision, lands a hard body shot.
But Ricky isn't moving his head too much still. His head is still right there. That is.
Oh my gosh, what a straight left hand. And will Hatton make it up from this?
Can he beat the count?
Is that it? And Kenny Bennett says, no way. That is that. What an amazing knockout shot. That is the most spectacular one-punch shot of Manny Pacquiao's incredible career.
Any fighter.
And I'm not sure if they're doing the right thing by moving Hatton around. I'm not a medical guy, but he's in very bad straight shape. Once Pacquiao stopped thinking knockout and went back to boxing, then he got the knockout.
He timed him just right. Tangled a perfect left-hand shot as he's coming in.
Landing 34 of his last 53 power shots. 64%.
And you know, Jim, the interesting thing is, before this fight tonight, he had shown this kind of power against the best featherweights, Barrera, Morales.
Take a look at this. Take a look at this.
This is a perfect time.
That was super slow motion.
Yeah, and he never saw a time him coming in.
It's the first time he's knocked out somebody like this since he was at 130 pounds.
And Hatton's head hit the canvas very hard.
He was knocked out as soon as
double
the punch landed.
Jeopardy. He was unconscious from the moment he caught that shot. Goes to the canvas in the proverbial heap, and boom. Out of our camera range at that angle, the head pounded against the canvas. Here's another look. So Floyd Mayweather made his statement on a podium this morning, saying, I'm back and I'm still the best. Manny Pacquiao makes his statement right here in the ring, knocking out Ricky Hatton.
And his trainer, Freddie Roach, had predicted it would not go past three rounds.
Carol Hatton is sitting down. Ray Hatton is standing up in the white shirt, looking away at the left corner of your screen. That's the Hatton family area in the crowd. They're hoping that their son is going to be all right. That's Hatton's fiance, Jennifer, in the red dress. And you can see the emotion on her face at this very moment. There's Ricky. And as we look at Ricky, we'll go up to Michael Buffer for the official particulars on the knockout.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the MGM Grand of Las Vegas, the end comes at 2 minutes, 59 seconds, round number two, the winner by TKO victory. And now, the new IBO and Ring Magazine light welterweight champion of the world, and still, pound for pound, the best in the world, Manny Pacman Pacquiao.
Woo! Two men have gotten the best of Ricky Hatton in his 47 fight career. Both of them knocked him out. Floyd Mayweather in 10 rounds. Manny Pacquiao in two. And all credit to Pacquiao's trainer, Freddie Roach, who was angry about the publicity, angry at everything that Hatton's trainer said about him, and said, my man will knock out Ricky Hatton within three rounds. He did it. 73 landed punches for Pacquiao out of 127 thrown. In other words, he practically couldn't miss. 18 out of 78 for Hatton, who was still scratching and sniffing and looking for some way to be in the fight at the moment when the end came. An amazing display of speed and skill.
But it was, his punches were so accurate. He was punching, slipping, ducking, and punching. I don't recall ever seeing a fighter that sharp that was doing offense and defensive at the same time.
Let's go to Larry Merchant in the ring.
Yeah. All right, thank you very much, Jim. Congratulations, Manny. Were you surprised how this fight went?
I'm surprised that the fight is kind of easy, but for me, I consider the fight is hard because he can punch. He have a strong left hand.
All right, let's take a look at the knockout, and you describe, what were you thinking at the time? Did you know that one punch could finish him? Describe it.
That's what our strategy, the one punch, hook by hook, left hook and right hook, that's going to be the key of this fight.
All right, but going back into the first round, it was your right hook that was doing the damage.
Yeah. The first round is, I expected my hook, my right hook is going to be dangerous for him because he's open while he's coming forward and his hand is down. So
you think he was trying to avoid your left hand, which is usually your power hand?
That's right. But he's very surprised because I have a new technique, the right hook.
Alex, Freddie, because you got the best training in the world.
Do you feel that a fighter who comes to you this way and tries to get to you, inevitably you're going to be able to impose your power on him?
I mean, sir, like what I said, I'm always doing my job in the ring and do my best to make people happy. And like this fight, and you know, there's nothing personal for me. It's I'm just doing my job.
All right, speaking of doing a job, let's go back to the first round and take a look at the knockdowns and describe them. The first knockdown.
Yeah, that's the right hook. We study that every day in the gym. We study that every day in the gym. If you see the 24/7, I throw a lot of hooks in the training. So that's why he's very surprised on that style.
Is this fight as satisfying to you as your victory over Oscar De La Hoya?
I'm satisfied. Nothing personal. I'm just doing my job in. I'm always trying my best in the ring, you know, to give more impression to the people.
All right, we all know that Floyd Mayweather Jr. is coming back. He's going to be fighting a fighter you had really tough fights with, Marquez. If he wins that fight, is that a fight you want, you and Mayweather?
Well, I can fight anybody, you know. It depends how my promoters negotiations are, and I'm just fighter and doing my job, training, and keep 100% in that fight.
All right, thank you very much again for a great fight.
Thank you, sir, and I hope everybody happy. Thank you very much to all of you guys who coming here tonight. Thank you.
Manny being Manny, and this is Freddie Roach being Freddie Roach. You predicted a third round knockout. I don't think we're going to hold it against you that you were wrong by a round. Why did you make that prediction? And what did you see happening in this fight that was going to make it come true?
Well, every time Ricky throws his left hand, he pulls it back and cocks it, and he's wide open for a short right hook on the inside from a southpaw stance. And we worked on that every day in the gym, the timing shot, and it just worked beautiful.
Did you know after that first round that, okay, now it's going to happen anytime, it's going to be over, or did you think that that Hatton still had the strength to make it a longer fight.
No, I knew it was over because Ricky doesn't have the ability, it seems like, to adjust. He fights the same way over and over again. I've watched tapes of him for the last 2.5 months. I know him pretty well.
What do you think about the possibility of Manny fighting Mayweather should Mayweather beat Marquez in July?
I think it's a very good possibility. It's a fight that if the fans want to see it, I think everyone, it's a natural fight out there. The two best fighters in the world, I think it'd be a great fight.
Thank you very much, Freddie. Thank you.